It was kind of a weird thing when I found out that Lou Reed was a fan. I had just decided that I was going to move everything back into storage, which is like something I've done a lot in my life, and just kind of travel around. And on the first day, I drove all the way through West Texas and, you know, desolate, barren landscape, and stayed at this really depressing, shitty, horrible motel. And I was kind of checked in, and there's that horrible, lonely motel feeling that you get. And I was just sort of like, feeling ground down, and I turned on my computer and checked my email, and there was an email from Lou Reed's manager, who was telling me that, like, Lou was a big fan, and it kind of made my life. It really was a really major affirmation for me, because hearing, you know, Lou Reed, like, who was this major guiding light for me when I was younger, say that he liked the band was like a huge thing for me. Growing up in New Hampshire really had a major influence on me even getting into music in the first place. I mean, my town is really, really small. It's just population 500, and there was really nothing to do. There was no places that were open past like 9. You know, you had to drive like an hour to get to the place that was open till 9, you know? So there was really nothing to do, and we would just do four-track stuff with friends, playing garages and stuff like that. So it was really strongly this kind of make-your-own-fun kind of thing. And in fact, when I was working on I'm Very Far, I really wanted to get back to the feeling of kind of being out in the woods with nothing to do and with this kind of sense of this nature breathing in through the windows and everything. So I actually went back to my grandparents' place, which is in this really remote town also in New Hampshire, and did some writing, and then went back to my hometown and kind of lingered around like a ghost, you know. And I listened to some of the demos I did as I was walking through the woods in my hometown, and I was trying to be like, does this feel right? Does this feel like it belongs here? It belongs in my head at this moment as I'm walking through this like field or up this hill. So it's funny that you bring that up, because I was really trying to kind of pull some of that back up out of myself for this record. Well, there was a song, White Shadow Waltz, that it's just a mean song, and I wanted there things to be hurt in it. So they were like, we were, you know, breaking things and throwing things, and there's this file cabinet at the studio that we were at that I was like knocking down and hitting and throwing across the room. But there were a lot of things like that where it was just sort of like things should be hurting, you know, inanimate objects should be damaged in this song, you know. In June, we're going to be doing a big American tour, and I don't really know yet who's going to be on the tour or anything like that. We're still sort of firming it up, but it's going to be like a big long, you know, 5-week going all over. And I'm really excited, because it's actually been a long time since we've been on the road. And this lineup of the band, it's just like, it's best lineup this band has ever had. And we've been playing really great and having a wonderful time. So I'm kind of just champing at the bit to get out there and do it.